Welcome to another episode. In today's episode, we will see the question first. Can perception exist independent of the perceiver? The question is, can perception exist independent of the perceiver? So what is perception? The ability to see, hear, or become aware of something through senses. The ability to see, hear, or become aware of something through senses. That is the dictionary meaning. So the question is a tricky question, but the answer is no. The perception cannot exist independent of the perceiver. For a perception, there are three things: the perceiver, the perceived, and the process of perception. Perceiver is differentiated from the perceived. That is the psychological space between the perceiver and perceived is because of the thoughts. I, who is looking at the chair, the table, or the moon, or whatever. So the I exists independently of the scene, the moon, chair, or whatever. And there is a psychological space which is created, I, that is because of the thoughts. That space is obliterated if thoughts are not interfering. The space, psychological space, not the physical space, the psychological space between the one who sees and the seen is obliterated. It is not there if there is no thoughts interfere. But the one who is aware, the one who is conscious, the perceiver, is always there. He is not obliterated. He is always there. So we will see a little more explanation. First is six means of knowledge in Advaita by Vedanta Swami Alokananda. Though all philosophers accept perception as a valid pramana, they differ about the details of process of perception. The Charvakas hold the gross body to be the means of direct perception and considers its presence their highest purushartha. The Nayakas hold that perception is of two types. According to them, perception is of the knowledge born of contact between a sense organ and its object. The Vedantins, however, proclaim that perceptual knowledge is nothing but Brahman. The Upanishads also declare that Brahman indeed is immediate and direct. Perceptual knowledge, according to Vedanta, is nothing but pure consciousness. The same unitary consciousness becomes threefold. Vishegata Chaitanya, consciousness associated with objects. Pramana Chaitanya, consciousness associated with means of knowledge. And Paramatra Chaitanya, consciousness associated with subject or the knower. The unified presence of the three divisions of the consciousness at the same locus constitutes valid knowledge. Incidentally, perception need not be external objects alone. It may be of cognition. I perceive a part is an example of the former. I perceive the knowledge of the part is of the latter. Then we will see an explanation from the notes on spiritual discourses of Sri Atmananda. How am I the witness? Every perception, thought, or feeling is known by you. You are the knower of the world through the sense organs, of the sense organs through the generic mind, and of the mind with its activity or passivity by yourself alone. Thus to him, every perception doubly reaffirms his knowledge that he is consciousness. But I exist, always changeless, whether perceptions occur or not, extending thought and beyond all states. So I exist always, changeless, whether perceptions occur or not, extending through and beyond all states. So perceiver is always there. So perception cannot exist without the perceiver. With this, we are answering the question. Stay with me for another episode. Subscribe to my channel. Thank you.